Tingis is the interesting map, but we're trying to do a full playthrough here, so onwards to Tarsus, which is not a pleasant map.
Syria and Judea recently joined our empire, but I question the depth of their loyalty. We require a major new trading port in the reliable border state of Cilicia. Build a city of 6,000 at Tarsus to project Rome's power near our new clients in the east. You'll be pleased to know that you need not grow food in Tarsus.
I'm not pleased.
This desert province has no farmland whatsoever. You must instead import all the food that you need. Many of Rome's eastern provinces chafe under our rule, and our legions are needed on other frontiers. You might face some military threats in the region. Although we have no sworn enemies there, neither do our allies waste any love on us. Defend your city and raise a legion or two of your own. Unlike Hispania or Gaul, where the natives are easily impressed, this region of the world has known civilization since ancient times. Your city of Tarsus must therefore achieve high ratings if it is to demonstrate Roman superiority. Finally, you would do well to show them how profitable trade can be in the Roman Empire.
Yeah. Better emphasize that the main point about this level is that you cannot grow food. That is not good. That is particularly bad. Right, what is this? This is Tarsus, right? Boom. So, we actually came in here with some starting funds. I'm going to give all that money to the city, 1792. And I'm going to build pointless things. I can build more expensive pointless things, surely. Yeah. And there we go. That way we're actually playing fair. Man, Tarsus. There's a lot of things I don't like about Tarsus, but there are a few good things. One is that it's very well suited for fishing. Lots of nice straight lines along here, fairly close to where the seagulls are, which is where you need to go fishing. But still, no food. No farming. Always feel strange seeing this pop-up menu and there is nothing there for farm. Okay, what do we have in terms of trading? We can make furniture, we can make weapons. Not great. Let's see. Oh, we do marble though, and straight away someone will buy our marble. That is something we're definitely going to want, so I'm not going to hesitate on opening that. Oh, it's C. Oh, okay. That's a shame. Well, this is a land trade route that I'll buy our marble, so that's nice. You'll buy our weaponry. Weapons are great. They sell for fantastic amounts of money. But selling furniture is also good. I don't see a problem in setting up all of those, especially the land trade routes, because I don't need to make a dock for that. Straight away the game is going to yell at me for not having an active dock, but so be it. So where do we even start with Tarsus? All of the mines are here on this island. There is not a speck of rock anywhere else on the map. I could use the entry and exit points, but that would be below me, so I'm not going to do that. So straight away I see something I want to do is establish mining over here. If I check the numbers yet again, they're going to buy... kind of tempted to set this up anyway, but I'll pass for now. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 iron mines to take care of all the weapon exports. And even more for all the marble exports that we're going to do. 0.4, 4.8 per year. So, like 5 quarries could take care of that. And then another 5 if I want to be selling them by ship. Marble sells for good money as well. 140, nice. And doesn't need any further dealings. So what it's telling me is straight away I'm going to want to get industry on this island. Not an easy thing to do, but something we're going to have to do anyway. Ship bridges to go across here will prove expensive, sadly. So that's the limitation of going over there. I could have a more cheap operation coming along here, but then it would just be like a little tent funding everything. which is not in itself too bad a thing. I will want to feed that little tent, though. Why did you build those useless buildings in the beginning, Jake? I wanted to get rid of my personal funds, because I do not like starting a level with any kind of crutch like that. Alright, I think it's safe to say we're not going to be building furniture on this island, so let's clear a path. I should be good with simply a low bridge here, right? Right? I selected low bridge, right? I would have thought that would be fine. Well, that is... Ah, see, there we go. That should suffice. At least that gives people access to here. Good, so immigrants can, if they are so inclined, make their way to my little island. I can check that by drawing that. Good, it works. And then I'm going to want a block here. Whether or not I can feed that block entirely on the fish here, I'm not so sure. This one I'm a lot more sure about. There's a lot of area here. Okay, I'm gonna make something then. Don't want to clear all this because I might need it later for making furniture. This is one of the troubling things about live building. Don't know. Difficult to plan all that much in advance, but hey, I'm doing what I can. So I'm gonna have a block here. It's probably gonna be a bit expensive to establish, but damn it, I'm doing it anyway. I'm gonna need labor here so they can draw from it, but maybe a bigger circle around here, which means houses will be along here? Potentially? Yes, yes, I'm well aware of my shortcomings, advisor. Alright, let's just do this then. Knowing that I'm going to have houses along here probably means I'll need a gatehouse or a figure of eight here. Not decided which yet. Go down this way. I have to keep in mind that there is great opportunity for another block here, but this will be our block to start with. I hope this isn't too big. Oh, I will feel right foolish if it is. It's 21 long. That might be okay. Might. It also might not. I can think of a lot of ways this could blow up in my face. Maybe I should reverse it though, so I'm not gonna have you there. 1, 2, space. Maybe another space. Another couple. Need to speed up a bit because the game always takes a wee while to clear empty plots. Alright, this will be our inner circle then. And alright. Risky, but we'll try it. Now, fountains only have a range of 3 on desert maps. I'm not a big fan of desert maps, but beggars and choosers, you know. Which means what exactly? I wonder if that'll have the range. I hope that has the range. Now, although this isn't a military map, there will be enemies that I have to fight. Thankfully, my block is way away from any edges, so my mighty army should be able to react in time. I wonder if that isn't central enough. Maybe I'll have to move it down a bit, which will be an expensive thing to change, but what the hey. Oh, damn. Or I could just say to these end guys, sorry, no water for you. Wouldn't that be funny? Also tragic. This is getting expensive. Also, I'm not sure. I'm not sure. There's a lot of things I'm not sure about here. There we go. That should do you. Right. But that means I need these... some access for you. And the thing about fishing is it doesn't take off straight away. You need to build boats with shipyards. So I'll need a shipyard straight away. I'm also going to need these places well engineered and well prefected. Hopefully one prefect is enough. He's only doing loops. Nothing should catch fire inside that time. Emphasis on should, because it always could. So I think I'm gonna have you there. I don't want that there, that's gonna get in the way of things. So what can I block it off with? And I'm gonna want to mark it there eventually, but maybe I'll just stick you there just to hold fire, as it were. This doesn't need to all be covered in road. But a good chunk of it will have to be. I'm gonna need a granary right here. It's gonna accept fish and nothing but. And then we're gonna have wharves. A lot of wharves. It's nothing to say there won't be industry going on over here, but I can reposition for that later. I can't remember, was there we go. Ish. Can I sell furniture by land? Oh, I can, right? Well. Wellity, wellity, well. I think we're going to be having industry then quite quickly. Raw materials, timber yard. One, a two, a... I am fundamentally against ripping up trees that I use for industry. It just feels wrong, so I won't do it. There we go. Means I need houses here. I think I want to leave a little bit of a gap here because it's as undesirable enough as it is. Oh jinx, I am running out of money so quickly here. Workshops, furniture, a one, a shoot. That was not the right place to put you, and I can't undo it. Well, there's 42 ducats down the drain. That's why it's good to plan. A 1, 2, 3, a 4, a 5, a 6. All this is going to need engineering. It's definitely going to need prefecting. It's going to need multiple prefecting. I'm going to slap down 2. You will accept furniture and nothing but. And I'd quite like to know who will buy my fish. If anybody. Okay, nobody by land will buy fish. That was all I cared about. Don't worry, Jake, I hear Caesar has an excellent interest rate. But you know what? I'm not interested. Alright, sell above 4 because I always like to keep a bit on my side. So these people are all going to die if I don't give them a doctor. And the gods are going to be on my case if I don't give them some religion. Oh well. Probably should put the religious guy next to the... Yeah, words are failing me today like nobody's business. I'll stick them next to the aqueducts, reservoirs, because it'll offset some of the "ugh, we don't like living here" malice. think the rest of them can go along here, and they will keep the desirability up. It will also cost me lots of money that I don't have. Leaving little spaces at two, just in case I can think of better things in the future that I want to build here. So that should be enough to get us going for now. Should. Oh wow, check those 2x2s. They're really good, with the exception of this one, that was perfect. Doesn't matter if these ones don't merge, as long as the ones on both sides that I want to merge also do. So that's good. So, I need this to work straight away. If anything, I should have staggered my dwarves later on, my wharves. And if there's anything else I should have done, it's keep prefectures as number one priority right now. Because now a lot of things that I need to not burn down are going to burn down. Oh, the shipyard was the number one thing I needed to work as well. Alright. Oh, thanks, Ceres, for boosting my... Oh dear, this is bad. Alright, guess we're having more prefectures then. That's also bad. A lot of bad news straight off the bat. So let's reduce... I'm not going to increase wages. Well, I'll have to stay competitive with Rome. Alright, so lost a bit of money on this. Oh, good lord. Wait, what was here that burned down? Was it a prefecture? Because that's hilarious. Oh my god. I think I'm going to be begging to Caesar faster than I thought.
Could you spare a little bread? I haven't eaten for so long.
Well, there goes my city. All those perfectly formed 2x2s as well. Well, that's my fault. I should have invested in more prefectures. How's that for more prefectures? Should probably also get my military on the go pretty soon too. Might be an idea. That's what I'm gonna have people coming off of this loop for. That was kind of nice of Mercury, but unfortunately this food is going to do me no good. Oh well, it is what it is. How am I looking at this then? It's going to be tricky because these do not have much range. Actually, it's not going to reach these guys at all. I'm going to need separate fountains along here. Which means I'm going to need a separate reservoir up here. Which also means these people are going to find it very ugly to live nearby. Well, it'll all be fine as long as my industry gets going. All be fine, he says. Sure need to sell some furniture right now. Sorry, Caesar. Alright, how's this gonna go down? 1, 2, 3. That should take care of everyone in the center at least. These guys at the top, I'll figure them out in due time. Well, Caesar gave us a load of money, so I might as well waste it on statues. Thanks, buddy. Should get most people up to something halfway desirable. Going to be difficult making this land desirable enough. I'll have to build some really nice things around here. So, I think it's market o'clock. Let's get rid of this and start feeding our people. It's a big block. They're going to need a lot of markets, but they're very close to the granary, so it should be alright with four. I am going to have to bite the bullet on the north here. And stick you. Throw in several gaps in the aqueducts just in case there are people moving around that don't get to. And with this, I can set up my fountains. Inefficiently, of course, because what's the point in doing anything correctly? 1, 2, 3. Don't even have the range to hit up these guys, but... Oh, no. Take that back. You've got it. So hopefully these guys aren't too hungry. Because I have no idea. I'm very bad at judging how much food wharves can provide. This is very close to where the fish is, so I like to think they'll give me plenty. As in, the fishing point is here. But I want to make sure that these guys can all be fully fed and have plenty of fish in the markets before I start upgrading them further. So halfway tempted to say degrade them further. Also almost works. We'll get another block off of these guys. I'm a little concerned because we could face an attack from this direction. So I'm just going to ignore that. That risk, that is. And just build here anyway, because why not? Live dangerously. Or don't live at all. Because what I need is barracks. I need it pretty badly. And I'm going to need a fort. Not Erfurt. But where? Where do we need our army? How about here? Seems suspicious enough. So I've still not set up those other industries that would be extremely lucrative right now. I guess I'm having too much of a soft spot for these guys. Thankfully we have tons of unemployment, so I can set these things up. Oh! Enemies are at the door. I'm probably gonna die. Well, now what that calls for, military academy. And another fort, this time for cavalry. You know, the strongest. Right, I am very nearly out of money, so I'm going to give everything I've made to the city just to keep myself afloat. So good, we are kind of breaking even on that food. They're not making their way along here, though. Oh, okay, that's just because things are undesirable. I'll build up some plaza, and I might very quickly have to erect some walls. Because I don't think a not-complete Prima Legion, even with the full academy training, is going to cut the mustard here. I mean, I could be wrong. I'd love to be wrong. Also, the gods hate me. Doesn't matter at all if Ceres hates me, which is quite amusing, because I don't have farms, as Caesar was keen to remind me that I should be very happy about. I'm not happy about it, but needs must. There we go, that should keep the gods alright-ish for a wee bit. This guy isn't alright, he is very not alright. These guys neither, Maybe I should build them something here to keep them a little bit happier. I've got it. Statues make everybody happier. So does being taxed, but I'm not currently taxing people. Alright, I can, however, start giving them some entertainment. Part of me wants to build something grander here, like a Colosseum, so I'm going to spare myself a little bit of space there. There we go, this should be fine. I'm going to let these guys fill up. And then let... I don't often do this, I normally just upgrade to small castle and be done with it. But I'm going to let these guys fill up with people and with food, just so I can judge that my food supplies are alright. I think and hope that they are alright. Lower your salary, Jake. Oh, I'm still on Adele. Right. Procurator salary for me, then. Okay. So far, so not bad. I would still like to start up this, though. What can I do? I actually want to feed the people that end up here, so at least they can live in small casas. But boy, do I need to do a lot of mining. Let me remind myself what I need here. 5 iron mines. And 10 quarries? That's crazy talk. I'm not even going to have the money to put that down. I'm going to have to speed up a bit. It's almost worth taxing these people, but not quite. Let's give them... what are they going to need? They're going to need a bit of school on both sides. So that should cover both sides. It does not cover both sides. Maybe I made this whole thing too long. That's a shame. But it's not a shame that can't be overcome by sticking a school here. It's undesirable as a neighbor, but... yeah, maybe I could stick one school here and one school there and be done with it. Speaking of being done... okay, they're over there. Whilst everybody is out fighting, I'm gonna get some backup javelins. Probably correctly calculating there's no quick way through all this. Alright, doesn't look like a dangerous arm. I hope I'm playing on the right difficulty. Thank God. I'd feel like a right fool if I wasn't playing on hard mode. And yet still getting scrubbed out. Small temple, Mercury, throw you there, throw down a school where the old one was, and then hope that that covers everything. Right on time, Caesar. I definitely don't have that available. But I will. Okay, take him down. Oh, okay, they're about projectiles then, because so am I. Who are these jokers anyway? I can't click on them because my own units are in the way. No problem, not a single loss. I overreacted there. Oh wait, I see the problem. The school isn't going to reach these people. What was I thinking? Evidently I wasn't. Okay. Problem. Solvable. Don't worry, tearing down schools, specialty of mine. I just hope that gets everybody. Not a problem. Hey Jake, I'm sure this was asked about 1,000 times, but I just tuned in. How do you get Caesar 3 in 1080p? Just Google Caesar 3 1920. Because some kind soul out there made an EXE of it. And the game is available on Good Old Games, which is where I'd recommend picking it up, because it's where I got it. Even though I own like 2 or 3 copies of the game, I just bought it again so I'd have an easier to get version of it. You're not getting employees. You are, though. That makes you a dangerously useless prefecture. I don't like dangerously useless. So have you there, then. Alright, this looks borderline acceptable. Don't like how you don't have any access to things there. Let's smack down a forum. And let's start taxing our people. 8%. And I'm actually going to raise myself 8 above Rome. Risky, I know, but I'm doing it. Alright, things seem stable, but Caesar wants his iron, so I'm going to have to set that up for him. The get. Where do I even start with this, though? Oh well, let's just throw things down and hope for the best. So I needed 5 iron mines at least. 1, two, three, four, five. And I'm going to need a lot of marble. Maybe I should get another iron mine so I can have an extra... No, I'm not going to do that. That'd be daft. I'm going to need a lot of marble quarries as well. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I have to deal with that for now. And these are going to burn down in a moment's notice, aren't they? Oh, damn. Okay, that changes things slightly. There's a little bit of water getting in our way there, which is a shame. So, I have a solution in mind for this. The solution is figure of eight. Do we have somewhere that we can get low bridges along here? We kind of do, and I'll take it. So where's the figure of eight? Have its little cross bit then. I should have thought about that, shouldn't I? I mean, this isn't quite the figure of eight that I'm looking for because... Well, what the hell, we'll roll with it. What's the fun if you don't... just throw caution to the wind sometimes? Still, these guys are going to do nothing without a bit of labor access, so ka-ching and ka-chong. One engineer should happily take care of the whole thing, but I'm thinking three prefects? And I'm not even close to what I need on the quarries. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I want at least 4 more. What a stroke of luck. It all worked out. Also, I'm out of money. Not a problem, I'm sure. Oh man, that's lucky. They merged together really nicely. Also, they have no water, but I think I can worry about that later. They can just have a well for now. Well, well. And they're also going to need... I don't really have the industries, or at least the space, to industrialize them very well. I could solve that by having the industry over here for the iron. It just needs to go whee. That's not very far to go. I think it should be okay, but I need the denarii for it. For now, though, I'll just set up a warehouse for the iron, because I know Caesar wants it. I'll make money in no time, right? Where does the... Okay, this is where the ships are coming in. I'll save myself a lot of time if they only have to go to here. So this is where all the marble goes to. And hey, I've got no money at all. Maybe I should remember that from time to time. Let's give everything I have to the city. And pray for the best. Like selling all this furniture, that'd be a nice start. Good. Dock time. And hold the phone. Right, you're not someone that buys my marble, so never mind that. Marble sales, more than 8. And Caesar can get off our back. Okay, that almost all works out. Unemployment is still healthy at 41%. Don't like this little hovel there. I know it's not a hovel, but... Oh, actually, it is a hovel. Well, damn. little bit of plaza here and there, and it'll be a casa. Now I do want to feed these guys, believe it or not. I could set up a little wharf right here. Here would actually be better, but... Okay, this doesn't... Oh, right, the gods are pretty angry at me because I haven't been oracling my way up. There you go, there's some oracles for you. I could probably throw one down right here. Or here. Yeah, if I didn't need those prefectures. In fact, I might not need prefectures anymore. They're not tents, so I'm gonna play dangerous and get rid of them. And replace it with a beautiful oracle. Okay, the gods will probably still want to curse me, but that's their problem. And explicitly my problem. One of you will do, and I just need a granary nearby-ish. Probably there will do. The nice thing about where buildings are positioned here, is that they generally have a place to go to, so a granary here won't screw everything up. Might screw up prefects a little bit, but eh. There we go. They'll get their food. I can feed these guys so they won't hate me so much. They'll still be a bit angry, but eh. And since I know attacks come from up here, I'd be a lot happier to establish an army right here. There we go. Might consider a bit of legionnaires later on, but I don't think this is the kind of map that requires it. Nothing to trade, just passing through. Please, I need to import food, says Caesar. So, market lady, for some reason, is not grabbing food. There we go. Wait, what? Good, she got her food. These guys, oh, everything is so undesirable to live next to, they don't want to evolve. Well, we can't all live in the Ritz, so there you go. Surround you with plaza and give you a couple of these things. Now quit being such a wuss. I've got industry to set up. This could work. It also could really not work, but I'm trying it anyway. Gonna throw a gatehouse here. Nobody should pass through here. What was that? Okay, more battles are on the way, but... I've got an army that even Rome itself is jealous of. So what's going to happen is I need another block here. Probably not as big as this block since the population requirement is only 6,000. Still, I do want it to actually have people. What kind of block will I make here though? And really, there's going to be warbs right here. How many warbs? 1, 2, 3. It's a shame, because I could get 4 if that wasn't there. But I can have another one there. That kind of works. Could even get rid of all of this. Smack down a granary here. That's a bad decision, as long as I don't have... I If I don't have anything here, any houses, any prefects, any engineer posts, that remains a pretty bad idea, but it's still there. Trying to think what I even need here. Lots of industry. Lots and lots of industry. Tons of it, in fact. One, two, one, two. Which means houses are going to be here, which means I'm going to have a block here. So what's the block going to have? I don't think I'm going to be able to feed that many people, though. Maybe... I really don't know. That's a troubling thing. Thankfully, Caesar really wants iron, and iron's what I'm stockpiling here. What's the stance with pottery, though? I can import clay from you, or pottery from you. The clay has to come by sea. That's a real pain. Thankfully, the prosperity requirements are not very high, so I don't even think I'm going to bother upgrading these guys past what they are right now. Which might seem super cruel, but that's what I am. But I want to make sure they can actually survive with this. Also, they're going to hate living next to this thing, so... Yeah, some large statues, because I can quickly forget about my money woes. Jake, can you give him back his legions? Nah. This is actually a nice map for inviting Caesar to fight you. Because he comes from here, and there's no real housing that you're going to be putting there. Very easy to defend against. I'm laying these down because I'm fairly confident I have plenty of food to be given these guys. Still need to think about the block here, though. What's it going to be? It's going to be here, that's for sure, so... So there have to be people here. How about this? It's nice and simple. It's also... disastrously difficult to water. But what if the water was here? That's not something I often slash ever do. Seems like a whole lot of wasted space, but I've never done it before, so that's good enough reason to try it. And then they'll probably want some niceties along here. Give them a space of two for that. Yeah, why not? I'll go with that. Oh, that's why I never do that. Because there's no road for it in the middle. Funny how you can forget those things. Oh well, I hope these guys are happy to merge. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And it's a small loop. One prefecture should be plenty, right? Yeah, they are going to need a granary here. How's the granary going to work then? In that way and out the other, I guess. No one can fault that, right? And then all the wharfs. Kinda interesting, I could slap another one down there, but it seems a little out of the way. Hopefully those will feed these guys. Speaking of people that are about to get fed, I wonder if this pathetically small army will be able to dispatch you. I'm confident it will. Because they use projectiles, so... Yeah, they will not be able to get past that. Lovely. So forgive me if you're noticing that not a lot of love is going into Tarsus. As I mentioned before, I'm not a big fan of Tarsus. So I'm going to be hoping a lot of these guys squeeze into 2x2s here. That's nice. Those that don't, I'll probably just burn them. Because I don't care for them. I don't even know how many I'm going to be able to feed with this. That's part of it. And tax them till they're dead. And give them a doctor so that hopefully they don't die too quickly. Right, it's high time I set up all that industry I said I was going to do. Unfortunately, the dock is far away from any of these, and the bulk of my weapons are going to be sold by sea. 15 only by land, huh? Well, I mean, I could have a warehouse here that gets them, or I could just have them make a long journey. Or I could set up a second dock that's significantly closer. Like right here. In fact, that could be the main dock. That's a lot smarter. And remember, there's a significant difference between marble and iron. Marble takes a hell of a long time to produce. Alternatively, I have this be where the weapons go, rather than the iron. Oh, now I have to set everything to not accept wine since I started up a wine route. How much easier is this to deal with than open TTD? A lot. Also, wasn't there room for a wharf here? Ka-ching. Right, so I need about 10 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The iron goes from here to there and comes back as weapons. Just in case, I'll set up another weapons workshop. It might be a little inefficient, but it should make me so much money that I don't care. Can also see how well these guys get fed. Hopefully reasonably well enough. Well, the gods are surprisingly happy, the enemies are closing in, but again, not really a concern now, is it? Ah, it's kind of nice and relaxing, this. I really do wonder why I stuck these in the middle. Well, it was to try something different, at least. Someone in the old Caesar forums calculated fish production. Yeah, I saw that. Unfortunately, that's not a formula that I can very quickly use in my head, because I don't know where the fishing... Okay, the fishing point is here, then. Does it calculate for diagonals? Oh, well. Better get more oracles down, or else a lot of people are going to be not very happy with me. Gonna stick some gardens along here, because people can use it to walk across. And how's the fire looking here? I don't trust that prefect one bit. If the RNG was bad with me, that could have caught in flames easily, so there you go. Otherwise, fire looks good. Damn right it looks good. So let's get all those weapons produced. How did I make that mistake? I think I want you to get your weapons. And now I can sell them. All exports over 4 are fine. I think the tax income is at least reasonable right now. Taxes in, yeah, 2.5 grand. That does not cover wages, but it's something at least. Gotta stay 8 above Rome, or else my people won't think I'm that benevolent. Two, three, right, that won't be far enough, but if I replaced you with a fountain, that would cover everyone. But I am not in the business of letting everything go up in flames anymore. So I'll switch you out of touch. Understandably, they want some fun, and they're probably going to want some education. You can read these people like a book. And on a note of that, I'll stick down a library. That should get everybody there. Pretty ugly. I mean, imagine having to live here. It must be horrible. At least this is a bit better. Okay, all is borderline reasonable. Pretty low population, though. Which means low unemployment. Only 500 sods are unemployed. Still though, I mean, I'm not interested in making the most beautiful Tarsus in the world. It's not a beautiful city. Favor will gradually go up, and it'll go up a bit faster if I send him some cheetahs and giraffes, despite them being heartless creatures. Prosperity will rise, but it'll rise a lot faster once I build a patrician block. The question is, where will I build a patrician block? Where would be interesting to put patricians? Is there anything interesting in this map? Other than Caesar's massive iron fetish. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if there are some inefficiencies here. No, actually, that's the last place that there should be inefficiencies. I think it's just that the iron was established before these. What I'm going to... Nah, let's not do anything stupid. Characteristic though it may be. So I don't need to sell any fish. I'm doing just fine on the selling of my my marble. I could probably be selling a lot more, but we're flush, or lush, or whatever the phrase is. So no need to worry. Could definitely squeeze in more houses here, though. It's just going to show that I make a lot more off of fishing than really I was giving fish credit for. Alright. They're gonna have to die. Sorry, not sorry. Let's just get them out of the way so I don't have to hear that distressing noise. And more tourists. I guess the fishing point is so close it just makes tons of money, and I'm okay with that. This I'm maybe not so okay with. If that amount keeps going down, then I'll have a concern about the overeating in this area. This is why Tarsus is uninteresting to me. Can't grow your food. There's no real military threat. I don't like desert maps as a general rule of thumb. Oh well, I should try and not just complain my way through this. I should just beat it. Culture, prosperity, peace. Peace will go up on its own. But I need that prosperity, so I need to think, how am I going to get patricians? I can import pottery if I want to be that decadent, but wine has to come in by sea. Which kind of makes this the ideal place for some patricians. I should set that up straight away. I can just have a getting warehouse for some furniture, that's fine. Wait, how does wheat come in? Is that by land or by sea? To shreds, you see. Ah, both, actually, that's good. Oh well, not looking for anything too extravagant here. Aye, that should do. Little ugly, but it should fit in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I don't know, a number of patricians. Throw down a granary right there. Unsurprisingly, they will take in the fish, which means I need someone else to take in the wheat. Wheat that'll have to be imported, mind, but that again can be dealt with. I can just have it come in by land. I don't think it should be too punishing. How many people does 25 bits of wheat cover? Wait, is it 25 by land? Aye, it's 25. It should be plenty. And if it's not, I can supplement it with you, who's right there. Hopefully this works out. There's a good chance it could not work out horrifically. Just one of you will be fine, but I suspect one each of you will be more fine. So we'll get our food. I will need to set you to import wheat, mind. What's the meaning of this? Does mean I'll have to sort out some other industry though. I wonder if I can have my oil industry here, and we just have a getting warehouse for it. Or if I could have... They come in by land, which is fine. So maybe I should have a gatehouse here? Nah, that's too risky. In many ways. I have to leave this completely completely removed from the other blocks. We'll buy in the wine here and just have a getting warehouse for it. The warehouse can also get pottery and... Oh, there's a thought. Maybe I can also have you accept in some pottery. And I can import both of them. And it's your job to go and get everything. Might seem a bit heavy going, but there won't be many buildings here, so I won't need all that many of each of them. Still need to find a way to create the oil that I need. This might be a little too far away for it. But there's not really the space here, and there's certainly space here, but it's an even longer distance for you to go. You're getting all of that. Maybe I could tell you to get olives as well. 1, 2, 3, little risky that. Oh well. One oil workshop will make oil for 20 buildings, so I'm in no doubt that it will be able to deal with my patricians, as long as you go and get it. Okay, I need to start feeding these people or else they're going to go up in flames, and they won't like me for that. Wait, what did he want? Did he want more iron? Of course he wanted iron. At least it's a good way to keep him happy. Unfortunately, these people are only going to eat wheat for a while, so I need to give them some really nice things to play around with. And naturally, they need religion. I can still get rid of Mars and Mercury. I want to keep them close to the houses so they can give their desirability bonus. Otherwise, stay in school, learn to read. They're going to need a doctor, they're going to need a barber. I think I'll just slap down everything they're going to need. And that certainly includes a bathhouse. Smelly Romans. Kinda cut myself a little short there, but I can stick you here. I should give them a little out here. It's going to be a little busy for them, but too bad, they'll have to deal with it. Forum, because I can't not tax them. And hopefully this all works out. I mean, I'm getting a little gung-ho here. But it is what it is. Hopefully I haven't missed anything. Plaza for a lot of them, and they're definitely going to want statues because these are Romans we're talking about. Right, hopefully nothing gets imported to here that's going to clog it up. That would be very bad. Like you, for example, you're getting in the wine and the pottery. But again, hopefully nothing clogs you up too much. Okay, that's the problem I was thinking of. I can get around that, though. Your problem is that you take in the pottery. So what if you are also set to get oil and get furniture? The problem there is you're actually going to be tied up too much if I make you do that. You there, you can be set to get furniture and get oil. I'll monitor the wine situation. Otherwise, it should be good. The barber isn't working. That'll be much better for you. Annoyingly, Rome has increased the price of wheat, which will make life a little harder for me. So I still need to get that oil, which should be being produced over here. Slowly but surely. Or am I not importing... No, I'm importing olives. My question is, where are they? Okay, this isn't good. I don't have enough food to feed all of these people, so... Away you guys go. Hopefully it'll stabilize out with that. So where's our oil? Perhaps I need another oil workshop, or else they're not going to give me any reasonable amount of it. Olives, that is. Yeah, they definitely come by land, so give them to me. Well, that's one thing to give to me. Right next to the prefecture as well, that's a real shame. Oh, well, that was foolish. Evening, Jake. Hope your city is going better than Turkey. Oh boy, what's happening to Turkey now? This will be one way to age my my VOD. There's no room for this lot anywhere in the city. No room for this lot anywhere in the city. Now granted, that was a bit bigger than before. But I mean, I've got another extra army to the south that can deal with all that jazz. So very soon we should have our delicious oil up here. There we go. And up they go. They need wine, they're gonna get wine. 20 iron. Something wrong with this lad. Okay, that's a problem. I'll stockpile iron for a while. Right, you need a doctor now. So, no, not a doctor, you need a hospital. I am lacking space for that. Could move the school. We'll move the school. I remember thinking it's such a big thing to get patricians. Really, they're no big deal. It isn't that nice. My concern is that they might be a little too hungry. I hope they're not, but it's a concern nonetheless. So there we go. Easy peasy. And now, a decent amount of my income will come from these. You can't get grander than a large villa in this map, because there are only two types of food. Grand villa requires a third type. So, that's a shame. Oh wow, that was fast on the iron. Wonderful. Take me iron. And there we go. That'll also work wonders on the prosperity. It'll take a while to tick up, but it will rise, much like our peace is. Which means the only thing I have left to do is get a bigger population. This seems like a reasonable enough place to settle down. It must be so clear that I have no love to waste on Tarsus. I'm just... not head over heels with this city at all. Plenty of wharves. Keep them good. And this is going to be absolutely nothing fancy. Probably feed a lot of people though, so maybe I should make a fairly big loop here. Wasting all this potential wharf area. Crimes against architecture. Oh, right, yes. Good job, Jacob. As ever, prefectures, more is more. I think Damascus, where I have to go afterwards, is another desert province, so that doesn't do me any favors. That's nice to be rolling in money, though. This isn't going to be going anywhere without a granary mine, so... There we go. Just want to make sure these guys are still doing good, still making me money. Of course they are. And when it comes to tax, not unreasonable sum out of them either. Hmm? Okay, good. This is so sloppy, this entire design, but oh well. With this block, I should well exceed the population necessity. Neptune can be the lucky guy here. Jake, looking forward to Hoi 4 MP next week. That depends. Umbasa is next to me, and Umbasa really wants to kill me. Probably. I mean, I knocked him out last time and called him a waste of manpower. So it wouldn't be beyond reason for him to want me down. Might as well use this little block to inflate the curriculum. Huh. Well, that's kind of funny. The wharf falls down, it obviously takes the ship with it. Thankfully, a shipyard can store two boats. One right there, and another with the 100% complete. So, at least I think it can. Hope it can, because I'm suddenly very short on it. And... I don't even think we're going to need that iron for you. And I'm so confident in that, as I make a safety save, that I'm going to speed forward. Prosperity will rise thanks to these. Actually, prosperity will take a little while to rise, especially if that's what's needed. An extra hippodrome would make it rise faster, but... Ah, well. Forget Caesar, he's not that important. Costing me a lot of money with that, though. But I think taxes now 7 grand pretty good. Far exceeds our wages. This is far from the greatest of patrician blocks, though. In fact, this whole city is something I can't say I'm proud of. I just wanted to do Tarsus. It's a yucky map, and I don't like it. I don't think this is sustainable, though. I'm actually running out of food here, so I probably have to tear down a few of these. But not right now. Oh, well, I do have enough to make Caesar happy. There you go. Take my iron. Prosperity will go up. It'll probably take a few years to finish it. It'll take a few fewer if I make a hippodrome. Wait, how's unemployment? Beautiful. Here, have a hippodrome. Have a chariot maker for the hippodrome. Pretty sure an active hippodrome increases prosperity by one or two per year. Various other things like turning a profit, not being in debt. Types of food eaten? Maybe not. You see, prosperity goes up by a bit each year, but it also has a cap. The cap is determined by the maximum, or rather the average quality of houses, which is why it's bad to have one by ones. Alright, so it was at 50. Oh, it's still at 50. Well, that's interesting. Two ways to go about that. I'm going to take the horrible way of deleting people's homes. As long as I don't go below the population limit, then that'll be fine. This is unfortunate. There we go. Yeah, this is the unfortunate part. I can get by doing something. Having a shipyard in a different place. That'll do. And then replacing this shipyard with a wharf. And then I should get a considerable bit more food here. Get off my back, Caesar. Might as well just keep that there. It's not doing any harm to anyone except my wages. Alright, so food stocks is actually a real problem here. Maybe the problem is inefficiency. You, for example, are waiting for that guy to get back before you can go and deliver your fishies. So I'm actually going to throw a garden here, all along here, which you guys can actually use to go back and forth, but most walkers won't. Random walkers won't, at least. Jake, perhaps a Turkish-Hungarian alliance. I would love some Romanian oil. Is that where you squeeze Romanians until you can oil up your pans with them? Because I can get behind that. But yes, I have got some open hostility from... Alright, so I am really facing an issue here that this is not enough. Not enough... Okay, a few ways to deal with this. Could give some of you pottery or what?
I've never been past so many unemployed citizens before.
Preaching to the choir. It's great, isn't it? Yeah, I mean, I'm not exactly struggling here. I could just put down more patricians. It would be a bit of rearranging here, but it could be done. Wouldn't even be that hard. He says, looking at it, umming and awing. I don't want to tear down ones that exist, even though that would save me the most space. kind of need this little space for people to get in and out from, so building there is not the best idea, but I can smack you down there, and then you'll take care of that. More though, I need more. If I could reposition the library and another temple elsewhere. Thankfully the temple can come up here. Mercury right. There you go. There's always somewhere to stick a library. There we go. Which means you also have to go. Gonna be a bit tricky to water you though. Without that. These people are a bit unhappy since I've made life a little more undesirable from them, from tearing things down. They don't like the noise and smell that comes from the Colosseum, clearly. There you go. That should keep you relatively happy. I could also throw that market elsewhere. If I were to find a little space for it. Or I could find a little space for you too. You're just little one by ones. One could fit there and one could fit there. Hope that works. It'd be really funny if it didn't. It's a really conveniently located marketplace, so it's a bit of a shame to get rid of it. But needs must. Clearly I need more patricians. Oh, if I'm about to learn that that library doesn't work from there, then I will be most unimpressed. Oh dear, where are you going? Because you're not going here. These are about to devolve like nobody's business. Well, that was awful. Thankfully that got solved, but jinx, that was close. Just trying to juggle desirability here to get you restored to what you should be. You don't deserve to be there. Alright, you're causing issues being up there. I need a better place for you. And I'll be honest, I don't have one to hand. Oh well, there I guess can do. We just won't have patricians here, and instead we'll get them all going over here. Different place. And get you a job at my hippodrome. Population is going down though. Have I got devolution or? Well, I guess some of these may have lost people. Ah, of course you don't have the school access over there. Never rains but it pours. Also, how in the world did you get some marble there? Must have been that thing that I cancelled. Well, pains me to do this, but I guess I don't need taxes for the finish. Which means you don't have to be there. That will capture everybody. Good. It's a little touch more. So as long as nobody is living in complete squalor, that should be the end of this. Now it claims that the housing quality is holding us back. We'll see what happens at the turn of the year. Because I might just be able to do something really cheap. I want to be done with Tarsus. Alright. Next year all will be clear then, but what I will need to do is get rid of a whole bunch of 1x1s and make 2x2s instead. But I have a little bit of a plan for that. May as well do it here, where the food supply is the best. This takes a very noticeable chunk out of my population, but it will cause my prosperity to go up to the target, which is, yeah, 60, without question. I just need to let the year tick for that. Jake, I must ask, do you plan to go good old-fashioned fascist Hungary? Mind if I message you on Twitch about the match? You can certainly message me on Twitch about it. Hungary already starts as fascist. I don't really see the need to change away from it. In fact, it would be rather dangerous to change away from it. With people around me that want me dead. December and January. There we go, we're well at the population target. So what I can do is just this. Splat. The population will come in, we'll hit the target, and it'll be the end of this. So, save game, Tarsus stream, and done.
You are fast becoming my most valuable servant. Your mastery of trade made Tarsus exactly the city I had hoped it would be. The eastern provinces are more loyal today, thanks to you.